That family.
Exactly. They're wondering what they're doing wrong here.
I know it. All right. Eric Hansen reporting live for us. Thank you very much, Eric. Good to know no one was injured. Mm-hmm. Well, Chief Meteorologist John McLaughlin has spent this morning getting a bird's eye view of the damage.
He's live at the Ankeny Airport with the latest. And John, what did things look like from above?
Well, really, it was amazing to see how much damage there actually was out here compared to some of the reports we heard last night of maybe a 7 or 8 mile track. What we found going up today in the helicopter is the track is much more extensive. We have some video we can show you of what things look like from the air. And really, this particular first tornado started maybe 4 to 5 miles to the south-southeast of Sully. You mentioned the coal line manufacturing area. If you just drew a line between that and Pella, and went about 4 miles toward Pella, that is where that particular tornado started. This system had very, very strong winds, but even more significant perhaps was the width of this storm. We calculated with the GPS at times this storm was almost 0.8 of a mile wide. Now, the entire area of that 0.8 of a mile was not real strong winds, but certainly strong enough that to cause the kind of damage that you see here. Lots of snapped trees, roofs off buildings. Some of the more concentrated higher winds did pass very close to some homes and caused quite a bit of damage. And the first tornado, as far as we can tell, was on the ground for probably 17 to 18 miles, actually crossed across Interstate 80 and then weakened. And then a second tornado is the one that Eric Hansen was referring to, which caused some damage about 3 miles to the north of Malcolm. National Weather Service is on the scene right now, and we're going to compare here in just a little bit the images that they're getting from the ground with the images we took from the air, get an idea on the exact path length, the exact path width, and of course come up with that EF scale estimation, what we call the Fujita scale, now a new enhanced Fujita scale, where we look at a lot more engineering information, where the building's tied down, you know, where there are bolts between the sill plates and the foundation and things like that. So a lot of information yet to come this afternoon. Of course, tonight at 5 and 6, we'll have much more detailed look of the damage from at least two big tornadoes last night just east of the metro.
Amazing pictures, John. And as far as you've heard, any injuries?
Absolutely not. We stopped in Grinnell and talked to folks for a minute. Everybody heard the storm warnings. They were watching Jason on TV last night. Really a lot of awareness the storms were coming, and thankfully no injuries.
All right. That's the best news. All right. John McLaughlin reporting live from the Ankeny Airport. Thank you.